babies. Let's see if I can open this. We moved the babies out of their brooder into their own little coop out here. Still, watch out, babies. Uh-oh, got some icky stuff on top. And so, there's Moxie. She's my favorite. That's Rubia. That's Tinder. And there's Moxie and Mary. I think this is probably Moxie. I wanted to show you some of my boxes. So in this box, we have the baby kale coming up all over here. And we've got a lot of spinach. I planted a lot of spinach here. We've got some lettuce on the end. I just threw an onion down there to see how it would do. But one thing that I noticed was coming up in this box is this little, it's kind of like a weed, but it's just kind of like growing on its own. And I'm leaving it because I'm pretty sure this is purslane. I'm gonna have to check that. But if it is, this is amazing for omegas, super duper healthy. So I definitely want that to grow in as much as possible. I have sauteed purslane with some onion and a tiny bit of butter, and it is just a purslane sandwich. I mean, with rice or something, it is really amazing, an amazing, I don't know if you want to call it an herb or a weed, but I'll show you some of the other things that are coming up. This bed over here, we have, ooh, it looks like everything needs a drink of water. This is red chard over here that actually looks like the sun really got a hold of it today. That looks terrible. Ah, chard, is that spinach or that's green chard? There's some kale in the back and there is some squash. This is the zucchini squash. And I see some purslane coming in over here too. And these are the tomatoes. And there's gonna be more sprouting up over here on this side. In this box here, we have planted a bunch of kale over here on this side and some chard. And then what else is over here? Tomatoes, different tomatoes. And then the kids planted some watermelon on this side this morning, but I had to put some chicken wire over it because if I don't, then the dogs jump in here and they dig everything up. So if I put wire on it, I noticed it's too uncomfortable for their paws and they just don't even touch it. So once the plants start coming up, then the wire will come off and then I'll put a little picket fence around to keep the dogs out. Hey everybody, it is Saturday morning. Hope you're having a wonderful day. I just wanted to check in here real quick. So I'm on my way to an orchard that's nearby. It's local. I want to support local, if I can, local farming. I did pick up some kettle corn for the kids. They didn't have any honey yet. They said not until later this month, but I found some almond gritty natural almond butter, and so I'm gonna try that. I picked a humongous amount of apricots. I did get a good bunch, a couple good bunches of different types of kale, so that was really nice. I found some nice tender little leaves. The worms were out trying to eat holes in them, so but that's fine, they left plenty for us. I'm making my family some Rockin' red velvet pancakes this morning. It is a Hungry Girl recipe, and these are usually mom's special treat, but my guys have been working out in the yard all morning, so I'm gonna treat all of them. Cut a few too many oranges for breakfast, so I sliced them even thinner, and I'm just using them to make some infused water for the guys. Long time no see. I've got a few tag videos that I need to get caught up on. The first one, and I apologize because I am like morbidly late. I got tagged about April 15th from my friend Kim over at A Girl and Her Phone. I love her to pieces. And I
actually did that tag. It was a quick and easy tag, ironically enough. And I did the tag, but then before I put it up, I realized that my dogs were barking incessantly in the background, and I'm used to hearing them, but I didn't realize how irritating it could be for somebody else. So I didn't do it. I didn't put it up. So I wanted to do it though, because I love tags. Even though I'm late, I do want to send you on over there to Kim, if you don't know her already, at a girl and her phone. I'll put her link below. She's absolutely wonderful. I'm not just saying that. I really, really like to hear her talk. She has this sweet Southern accent, and she does a lot of porch times, and I absolutely love porch time videos. It just makes me feel comforted and like I'm visiting with family or something, and I just love her to pieces. So anyway, let's do this quick and easy tag. And I was tagged by two other marvelous people, and those tags are going to be coming real soon. Active Rachel Ann and Frecky Fit Wolf also tagged me on some wonderful tags. So those are coming tomorrow and the next day. So let's get started on the quick and easy tag. Number one, when is your birthday? I am a July 3rd baby, and I was impatient, and I didn't wait 15 more minutes. I would have been born on the 4th of July, but ever since then, I've been the same. Just can't wait, and it was the 3rd for me. All right, number two, when was the last time you wrote a letter to someone on paper and mailed it? That would have to be... I'm getting my kids to write slow mail letters to family and friends, and then that way, you know, without them being able to go out right now a lot, I want them to still feel that they can communicate with, you know, their loved ones. And so that's going really well, and they're really enjoying that. Number three, what did you eat for breakfast this morning? Well, this morning I had a waffle made out of oats and a mashed banana and a couple other things that I used to have all the time. But this morning it was so dense, and it just kind of like stuck with me all day long. So I'll probably just go back to having, you know, my regular Hungry Girl oats tomorrow. I also had some purslane that grows in my garden, and I had that with onions and sauteed that with some egg white, and that was really good. I really am enjoying that wild purslane. Number four, who is the next band artist you will see perform live? Oh, wow, that's anybody's guess. This is Las Vegas, and normally lots of people come through here, right? But who knows when everything's going to get rolling again here, if and when, and hopefully, I'm sure it will. It's just how that's going to happen, and all these particulars are really being worked out right now. Last person I saw in person was, I think it was Andrea Bocelli, and I've loved his concerts in the past. I've been to a couple of them, but I think I would really like to see Ed Sheeran in concert. My husband's really not familiar with his songs, but I think I'd really like to see him if he ever comes to town. Number five, what is the last song you listened to? I know the last song I sung this morning was Puff the Magic Dragon. That must have been it. That was it. I watched it with my kids this morning, and that was it. Puff the Magic Dragon. Number six, if you could be fluent in any other language, which would you choose? I have tried Spanish so many times in my life. I took it in elementary school. I had it in junior high. My parents actually put me in a bilingual program in middle school, so that I could learn all subjects in English and in Spanish, because they didn't teach us Spanish at home. They kind of like hid Spanish, or they thought they were. They'd speak to each other in Spanish about things they didn't want us to know, but being immersed, and as a kid, you end up putting it together and picking it up. As a result, I know what people are saying in Spanish all the time, but I don't know enough people who are Spanish speaking that I can practice with, and so it doesn't fluently come out of me. But I know what they're saying. I know if you're saying something to me, I know what you're saying, but I sound like the village idiot if I try to regurgitate it. Took it in high school, took it in college a few times. We lived in Spain for 3 years, you know, and it's like, I mean, I get it for a while, and then it's gone, because, you know, my surroundings just are not, you know, in a place where I can practice it. So, in short, I would love to learn French. I think I'd like to give that a go and see how that goes. Do I know anybody French? Yeah, I guess maybe You know, that would probably go the way of Spanish with me because I don't know anybody. I'm going to have to get some French friends. Anyway, maybe hubby and I can learn together and then practice, right? All right. Number seven, does anything on your body hurt right now? Yes, it does. I have, my left knee gets kind of inflamed. It always has for many years whenever I do any workout on it. And so I just get used to that. But something else, my left foot, last year, I did a video on it. We took our middle little boy to a jumping place. It's like a trampoline park indoors to jump at for his birthday. And I really hurt my left foot. Well, I think what I did was I broke like a couple of toes and they never quite healed. I never went to the doctor about them. And so they still are very painful when I do a lot of workout on them, or you know, I can't bend them down anymore without pain and stuff like that. And I know they just need to heal. It's just one of those things. It's going to take time, but they've been hurting ever since last year in November. So that's one of the reasons why I think, you know, I was supposed to run a marathon this year, the Las Vegas Rock and Roll, which I really don't even think is going to take place this year, but you never know. It would be really weird, I think, in order to do, who knows if that's going to work or not. But number one, I don't want to pay for it and then it be canceled and then wait forever to get my money back. And number two, I really don't think I should be running and training that hard on my left foot given the broken toes. So anyway, sorry to get going off on that, on the aches and pains. All right, number eight, what's your favorite sports team? Well, in Las Vegas, the Raiders are here. Now, we don't necessarily believe in the Raiders because they didn't really have a good, history of winning, but we've always kind of liked them. And now that they are Las Vegas stationed here and we have their stadium here, hubby says we really should support them. So we're going to support them. So we're Raiders fans now. Yay. And we also have Las Vegas Knights, which is a hockey team in town. And I like them. I really haven't seen them play, but I hear they're pretty good. And, you know, where they want to show a lot of spirit there, too. So I guess it could be a little bit more enthusiastic for the Raiders. But I kind of feel like they should prove themselves a little bit more. All right. Number nine, how often do you watch the news? As little as I can. So I kind of get a lot of my news from all over, some even grassroots organizations and things like that. So I just really try to keep an objective view, get as much of the news as I can and make, you know, think for myself and try to just get as much evidence-based, objective stuff as possible and go from there. It's just, you know, how it is. All right, number 10, do you wear glasses? And you can see that I cannot read without these. And unless you're pretty close to me, I can't really see your face. So it's blurry. I've gone back to lightweight instead of those clunky ones I had last year. And I like these much more. All right, so those are my 10. I'm not going to tag anyone on this one because I think everybody has done this tag. I am so unbelievably late on doing it. Kim, I apologize for that, but I don't want you to be afraid to tag me in the future because I absolutely love tags. So please tag me anyway in the future and I will get a going on those a little quicker. All right, guys. I love you so much, and I will see you tomorrow in another tag. Bye.